folks, welcome to tonight's game between the Michigan State Spartans and the Miami Hurricanes. And, of course, we look here at our Star Watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Hey, Brad, we should really pay attention to the matchup in the middle. These kids are really skilled and worth paying special attention to. Expect a big game for one, if not both of them.
And the referee is ready to toss it up. The Hurricanes win the tip, and they're off and running. The Spartans, number two in the polls right now, Dick.
I love the way they attack the glass. They play with such a vengeance. They really want to get on the glass aggressively.
And a momentary look from three-point land. We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Working it around the perimeter for the bucket. Goes. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a little bit easier, wouldn't you say, Dick?
Tell you, Brad, pass and score at times are very difficult to guard. They're capable of getting off their own shot as well as create for others. He's fun to watch for those reasons.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Takes the pass in the paint.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
The shooting guard takes the pass. Looking for a good shot. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Tries for two. That's good. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Coach has been pretty active over here on the sideline, providing some quality feedback to his players. I overheard him saying that he really likes the manner in which they've been playing. The up-tempo style is what they're known for and what they've been demonstrating so far. Don't look for that to change.
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. On the right side. Inside. He shoots the jumper. This is getting ugly.
Hey, if you can't check your man, it's up to the coach to recognize that and make an adjustment.
Trying to pack it inside. Goes up with it. Off the mark. Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Bounce play on the baseline. For two. He can't get the bucket to fall. Off the glass and no good. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. Wing. They look to get it to the inside. Takes his jumper. Busts the J. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Off the glass. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Zone offense now. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. He's money with the shot. Down in the low block. He goes up with it. They get it to go. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Knocks it down. Number 20 takes the feed. Jumper won't go.
They stripped him in the basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
The Spartans move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
For three. Nope. He takes the rebound. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And score it.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Tries for two. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Goins handles the feed.
To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He attempts the three. He misses the jumper. On the left side. He pulls up with a jumper.
They're trying to build an entire neighborhood with all those bricks, Brad.
They need some buckets, and they need them in a hurry.
Up and inside. There's the trap. Great anticipation defensively.
He's wasting no time getting it up the floor. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you've got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, the two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. Hey, a player's senior year is such an emotional one. The key is to stay focused and not get caught up on being in your last year of collegiate basketball. If you focus on the right things, win or lose, it'll be a memorable experience.
Well, the arc looked good. He can't get one to fall. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For two, he buries the shot. Now they work it around the perimeter. He puts up the J and come up short. It around the arc. Lobs it. Brown handles the pass. Pushes it up. Now the turnaround jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the outside. His bad. Moving it around the perimeter. Here they come with a double team to stop it. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the mark.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots from the top of the circle. And he missed. Goes up for two. You betcha. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Sinks the shot. Brown receives the pass.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
With a bucket, he buries it. How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points.
In the lane. Can't connect. Goins handles the feed. Zone offense now. 7 minutes left on the game clock. Cross court. He wants a three. He misses the fadeaway. There's a slam. Number 20 is charged with the foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
Hey, being a student in college is quite an experience, but being a student athlete is something on a whole other level. There are a lot of challenges you have to meet if you want to keep your balance and be successful.
Second shot, good. A great trap initiated by the defense. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Down inside. Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. And now getting set up here to four round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work. I saw a play for that one. He got the good pass and threw it down, baby.
Perimeter. Lets it fly. Missed it. Tries for two. That was nice. For two. He drains the bucket. Goes up for two. He hits it. Did a great job of getting to the hoop on that one, Richard.
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points. You talk about versatility. There aren't many guys that are going to make that fadeaway jump shot. Great touch. Impossible to block that shot.
On the right side. Gladden sliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
On the dribble, gives it up. Count the bucket. That's a goaltending violation. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
It seems like he's everywhere at once. He's been making good decisions and been strong with the ball. The coach has got to be happy with his performance so far.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
4 minutes left on the game clock on the left side. They work the perimeter. That's not a good pass. Number 20 pops back into the ballgame after a well-deserved rest.
Wow, he makes such an impact on his team when he's in the game. At both ends of the court, Brad.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For the bucket, he nails the shot. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Number 20 handles the pass.
There it is, Jam City.
Alley-oop.
Wow, that was a classic alley-oop. Hey, the finger went up in the air before the screen was set.
On the outside. From the corner. And he hits the three. Adam, momentary look from three-point land. 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. Takes the pass in the paint. He gets it to fall. Right at the circle. Can't get the shot to go. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
Lawrence is a pretty good free throw shooter and will likely knock down his free throw attempts.
He really knows how to focus in on the target during free throws.
Got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
Number 4 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Working it around the perimeter.
Great shot block right there. Yeah, some good movement on the offensive side.
The Spartans go into their zone motion now. 1 minute left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. If everyone else is covered, give it to the guy in the stands. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Gets the J to fall. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the...
Rejects it. Shot clock is dead. He shoots from left of the circle.
Excellent jump shot right there.
And we'll get a change of possession. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
I tell you, if you're on the floor, that means your coach trusts you and believes you can play a role out there. Hey, we've seen some great plays from a number of different players so far, and that always makes things difficult for an opponent.
With the big shot, and he can't hit the shot. At the end of the first half, the Hurricanes lead by three. While we get a moment here, let's take a look at the keys for each of these teams today.
I've been really impressed with just how hard both teams are playing. These numbers show you how they've been performing.
Ward comes back into the game.
I tell you, they need their leadership out there. This kid's got leadership skills just like you, Mr. Nestler.
The jumper. Nope. Zone motion now. For two, scorches the net. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Hurricanes are really delivering on one of the points of emphasis that Dick brought up, establishing that inside game. The coaching staff is happy with what the team has been able to accomplish in this regard. It's worked so far, so look for it to continue in the second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He tries the jumper. Jumper won't go. The Spartans set up into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Trying to feed inside. Blocked. Knocks it down. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Got it down the low block. He nails the bucket. In the paint. There was no doubt about that one. Looking for a good shot. From right in the circle. Off the mark. Goes up for two. It's no good. The Spartans are going into their zone motion offense now. Working around the perimeter. For the bucket. Not there. Now trying to feed the low block. He attempts the jump shot. Busts the jumper. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
Out on the wing. Works the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Scores it. Handles the pass. The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Scorches the net with a J.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And now the fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, he uses the ball really well, too, in terms of putting it to the deck, turns, spins. He's got every move in the book.
Got it down to the low block. Puts up the jumper. Missed it. Tries for two. It's good. Looking to create with a ball screen.
Hey, the pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great way to buy a step for the dribbler.
He puts up the tray. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, they'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
They go into the low block. Goes up with a shot. Nails the J. Shots there if he wants it. With a jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The fake for two. The missed shot. Gave it up. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. The Spartans are going into their zone motion offense now.
Up and inside.
For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. There was no doubt about that one. Looking to move it around the perimeter. With the J. They get it to go. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. No good. Pushes it up. Jumper. Busts the J. The Hurricanes set up into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
They're working around the arc. Throws it up. He manages to keep it in play. He dribbles the ball out of bounds. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
I tell you, it can really cause the defense fits and throw you off on offense when a team can play strong across all five positions on the floor.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the deep corner. Missed the jumper. Had his shot blocked. Knocked it down. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
He takes a three. He misses the fadeaway. Makes the shot. On the outside. Lobs it. The shot from the baseline. Off the mark. The point guard receives the ball. If you call for it, he may throw it to you, too. Once again, let's take a look at our star watch. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
Shoots. Can't get the shot to go. The Spartans move into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Moving it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. They got it. We're at the 7 minute mark.
Look at that spacing.
They get that rejected. On the left side. Bridges picks up the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. That's on the nylon, MBM.
The Hurricanes are in a great position with the time and score on their side, and they're going to have to play more in the half court now, Dick.
Preserving the lead should be the primary focus. Continuing to play an up-tempo game would be very smart at this point.
The Spartans go into their zone motion now. The Spartans are going to have to make some modifications here, Dick. They're going to have to throw out the idea of playing in the half court and get this into more of an up-tempo game.
They'll need some quick scores and defensive stops, Brad. That's the only way they'll be able to overcome this deficit. Playing up tempo may not be their thing, but it's their only chance of getting back into the...
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Gave it up. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. Well, let's see who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. Takes the jumper and come up short. On the left side. Goes up, knocks it down. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Bed the low block. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. On the right side. Bad decision there by the senior. Now in transition. The Spartans now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
And score it. Tries the three. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. Four minutes left on the game clock. They're working around the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Jumper won't go. Defense is just getting caught out of position on those backdoor cuts, Dick.
Brad, those are the type of reads you look for in practice.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Bridges receives the pass.
Excellent jump shot right there.
3 minutes left in the game clock. Dumps it in. Jumper missed it. The Spartans now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
They work the perimeter. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with the shot. Buries it home.
excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. 2 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside, he tries the three. The sky is the limit right now with the three balls, Dick.
Hey, the defense better switch it up a little, or these kids will continue to light it up behind the arc.
Hard foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Lawrence steps to the line. Definitely one of the better free throw shooters on this team.
Mentally, he truly believes that he can knock it down. It's a trait that many good free throw shooters have.
Hits the second shot. And now getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes the first.
His first free throws count. Let's go back on our campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
The Hurricanes are cranking things up at the defensive end, and they're going to extend that pressure.
An aggressive move on their part, Brad. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
1 minute left on the game clock. Ball coming in from the sideline. They'll throw it in from the side. They'll throw this one in from the side. One plus one, if it's good, it goes in. It's the second shot. Trying to feed the low block. There's a double team waiting there. Can't elude the trap.
Hey, trap's giving that kid some fits.
Pushes it up, and they go into their motion offense, working with four round one here.
I love the four round one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Zone offense now. Side, inside, from the corner, drains it. Shot clock is dead. Got it down to the low block. He misses the J. Newton receives the pass. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Well, before we go any further, let's see who came in as our players of the game today.
Only one will walk away with the win, but both these kids gave it everything they had, and it was great to watch them compete.